When you hear a show tune from the great white way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street. You.
She's mine.
The mirror tells me she'll be mine again. Your flashing wit,
your flashing eyes,
your brilliant brain,
your brutal thighs.
These are the tools you've got at your command.
To make her mine.
To keep her mine.
To make her mine.
Your crooked smile.
Your inner fire.
That spells romance.
That sparks desire.
Cuddly, crunchy.
You've got what the ladies cry for.
Crafty, cunning.
You are what they gladly die for.
Talent, genius.
You're the stuff that dreams are made of.
Hey, man, lover.
What have you to be afraid of? What have you to be afraid of? You're almost perfect, but one thing is true. You need her desperately, but she does not need you.
She runs the show. She leads the band.
The royal flush.
Is in her hand.
Face it, old boy, you can't afford to fail.
Must not fail.
Dare not fail.
Will not fail.
So flash that wit.
And flash those eyes.
And use that brain.
And use those thighs.
Hey team, yay team, break right through the line. There is no stronger challenge than an independent woman.
You can do it, you can do it.
Got to keep her,
got to make her.
Well, both those two gentlemen seem to have confidence in themselves, don't they? Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, here on 88.3 WLIW-FM, Long Island's only signature, one-of-a-kind individual NPR station emanating out of Southampton northward to southern Connecticut and now westward, all along Suffolk County, through the Long Island Expressway westward. Well, that song was Mine from On the 20th Century, and you had two very talented actors there, John Cullum and Kevin Kline, both of whom took home Tony Awards that year. I guess it was the 1978 Tonys. And today's show is a kind of riff on that idea of, what would I say, self-possession, ego, confidence. You know, we're taught in, I don't know, from school onward that, modesty is a virtue. But as one character who we'll hear in a bit says, sometimes in the theater, modesty can hurt you. So let us look at those characters who have, I don't know, larger than life confidence, which is maybe something we would like to emulate in life. Well, I Have Confidence is the title of our show, and y'all know what that's from. That's from The Sound of Music, but it's not from the show, it's from the film. And when they made the movie in 1965, Oscar Hammerstein had passed away 5 years previously, so Richard Rodgers wrote these lyrics for a kind of character establishing song for Maria. And Andrew said, I could never figure out what the lyrics meant. I just sort of felt if I sang it fast enough, it would sort of make sense. And it was so indelible in the movie that they have added it for all subsequent stage versions. So let us go to a stage version. Here is the lovely, enduring Rebecca Luker singing about Richard Rodgers' brand of confidence.
I captain with 7 children. What's so fearsome about that? Oh, I must stop these doubts, all these worries. If I don't, I just know I'll turn back. I must dream of the things I am seeking. I am seeking the courage I lack. The courage to face them with reliance. Face my mistakes without defiance. Show them I'm worthy, and while I show them, I'll show me. So let them bring on all their problems. I'll do better than my best. I have confidence they'll put me to the test, but I'll make them see I have confidence in me. Somehow I will impress them. I will be firm but kind. And all those children, heaven bless them, they will look up to me and mind me. With each step I am more certain everything will turn out fine. I have confidence the world can all be mine. They'll have to agree I have confidence in me. Strength doesn't lie in numbers. Strength doesn't lie in wealth. Strength lies in nights of peaceful slumbers. When you wake up, wake up! It's healthy. All I trust, I leave my heart to. All I trust becomes my own. I have confidence in confidence alone. Oh, help. I have confidence in confidence alone. Besides which, you see, I have confidence in me.
I'm sure that you have heard the name Aldolfo, a ladies' man who wins acclaim, Aldolfo. Well, lovely miss, I am the same Aldolfo. I introduce myself, I am Aldolfo.
Nice to meet you, shall we?
Not so fast, so just in case you didn't hear, Aldolfo, I'll try to make it very clear, Aldolfo. The lovely ladies always cheer Aldolfo. When I repeat myself, I am Aldolfo.
Understood.
I can sing it high, Aldolfo. I can sing it low, Aldolfo. I can sing it very fast, Aldolfo. I can sing it very slowly. I do it now, but it would take hours. Now let us see if you can remember my name.
I'll give it a shot.
Now who's the fellow that you see?
Aldolfo.
And how should you refer to me?
Aldolfo.
And who is it I'll always be?
Aldolfo.
Now sing it proudly.
You are Aldolfo.
Spell it out for Joe. For all you lovely ladies that didn't hear for some reason, because maybe you are hard of hearing or something. I don't know. It goes I am Aldolfo. Aldolfo.
Well, that's a very confident, egotistical fellow, Aldolfo. And that was Danny Burstyn, who was married to Rebecca Luker. So that's a nice little pairing that we have there from The Drowsy Chaperone. Well, we currently have a character on Broadway who has no doubt, or at least no external doubt, about her talents. I'm sure, you know, in that dark hour of the night when it is always 4 a.m., as F. Scott Fitzgerald says, she may have some doubts, but not when she's auditioning for Mr. Keeney. And of course, I'm talking about Fanny Brice in Funny Girl, currently running in a revival here on Broadway. And here, of course, is the original Barbra Streisand, who kind of is the greatest star. So why not? Take it away.
Listen, I got 36 expressions, sweet as pie to tough as leather. And that's 6 expressions more than all them Barrymores put together. Instead of just kicking me, why don't they give me a lift? It must be a plot, 'cause they're scared that I got such a gift. Well, I'm miffed, 'cause I'm the greatest star. I am by far, but no one knows it. Wait, they're gonna hear a voice, a silver flute. Ooh, 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 ooh. They'll cheer each toot. Yay, she's terrific. When I expose it, now can't you see to look at me that I'm a natural Camille. As Camille, I just feel I've so much to offer. Kid, I know I'd be divine because I'm a natural coffer. Some ain't got it, not a lump. I'm a great big clump of talent. Laugh! They'll bend in half. Did you ever hear the story about the traveling salesman? 1,000 jokes. Stick around for the jokes. 1,000 faces. I reiterate, when you're gifted, then you're gifted. These are facts. I got no axe to grind. Hey, what are they blind? In all of the world so far, I'm the greatest star. Who is the pip with pizzazz? Who is all ginger and jazz? Who is as glamorous as? Who's an American Beauty Rose?
Today, we're looking at people who think the world of themselves. We may not think that's a good thing in real life, but on the stage, sometimes it's quite magnetic. And here is a young man who had a Canadian background. He grew up in Lawrence, Massachusetts. He walked in to audition for this show in 1960 wearing dungarees. They couldn't find anybody. But the minute he opened his mouth, Lerner and Lowe and Moss Hart realized they had their Lancelot. And of course, I am talking about Robert Goulet in a career-making solo. C'est moi.
Camelot, Camelot, in far off France I heard your call. Camelot, Camelot, and here am I to give my all. I know in my soul what you expect of me, and all that and more I shall be. A knight of the Table Round should be invincible, succeed when a less fantastic man would fail. Climb a wall no one else can climb, cleave a dragon in record time, swim a moat in a coat of heavy iron mail. No matter the pain, he ought to be unwincible. Impossible deeds should be his daily fare. But where in the world is there in the world a man so extraordinaire? C'est moi, I'm forced to admit, 'tis I humbly reply. That mortal who these marvels can do, c'est moi, 'tis I. I've never lost in battle or game, I'm simply the best by far. When swords are crossed, 'tis always the same, one blow and au revoir. C'est moi, so admirably fit, a French Prometheus unbound. And here I stand with valor untold, exceptionally brave, amazingly bold, to serve at the Table Round. The soul of a knight should be a thing remarkable, his heart and his mind as pure as morning dew. With a will and a self-restraint that's the envy of every saint, he could easily work a miracle or two. To love and desire, he ought to be unspeakable. The ways of the flesh should offer no allure. But where in the world is there in the world a man so untouched and pure? C'est moi. C'est moi, c'est moi, I blush to disclose, I'm far too noble to lie. That man in whom these qualities bloom, c'est moi, 'tis I. I've never strayed from all I believe, I'm blessed with an iron will. Had I been made the partner of Eve, we'd be in Eden still. C'est moi, the angels have chose to fight their battles below. And here I stand as pure as a prayer, incredibly clean, with virtue to spare, the godliest man I know. C'est moi!
Disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd love to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you, and it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston, no one's quick as Gaston, no one's neck's as incredibly thick as Gaston. For there's no man in town half as manly.
Perfect, a pure paragon.
You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. Who plays
Dodge, I guess, on
who breaks
much more than the sum of his parts like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
I want a guy like Gaston.
I needed encouragement. Thank you, LeFou.
Well, there's no one as easy to bolster as you.
Too much?
Yep.
No one likes like Gaston, douses likes like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody bites like Gaston.
When I hunt, I sneak up with my quiver.
Ooh.
And beasts of the field say a prayer. First I carefully aim for the liver. Then I shoot from behind.
Is that fair?
I don't care.
No one hits like Gaston, matches wits like Gaston.
In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating.
A lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a barge.
Josh Gad and Luke Evans, an ensemble from the live film version of the animated Beauty and the Beast, that's Gaston. Do we think maybe that they had some sense of who Lancelot was in Camelot and took Gaston, another Frenchman, to the next level? Very amusing song from that film. Well, if Lancelot and Gaston are knights and warriors and big-chested baritones who can bestride the earth, what about a 12-year-old who goes to a private school in New York City? Where does she stand? Well, if it's Alice Playton from the musical Henry Sweet Henry, you'll understand that though Kafritz may be a young lass, she is indomitable in her own way. Here is Alice Playton with the show-stopping number from Henry Sweet Henry.
There. I did it. But I endeavor to resist them by clenching my fist, and by kicking my shoe hard I try, but not too hard. She was out to get me, but I got her first. When she got malicious, she happened to pick a kid who'd be just as vicious and twice as vindicative. I am rough and I am ruthless, though it's tough, the bitter truth is nobody steps on Kafritz. If they do, then they must be crushed. If the world starts a ruckus, where all of them run amok is to step on Catherine, my friend.
Alice Playton from Henry, Sweet Henry. Tony Randall was offered the lead in that show, Henry Orient, the character Henry Orient, played by Peter Sellers in the film. He says, it's a wonderful show. I would love to do it. If only I were a 12-year-old girl. He realized the girls stole the show, and indeed they did. Well, if we can think of one actor who embodied the self-serving, egotistical, oily, megalomaniac in the history of shows, it would have to be Jack Cassidy, who seemed to play that role in almost every show he was ever in. Here is one from 1964, where he plays a matinee idol. I think his name is Byron Prong or something. At any rate, it's the early era of Hollywood, and his fortune is his face.
Fortune is my face, laughing, crying, smiling. Look upon this face, wistful, scornful, and beguiling. Right profile, left profile, three quarters, and full face. Perfect, every angle right. Cameraman's delight. 32 dazzling teeth, a sight divine. 32, one of them is almost mine. My fortune is my face, manly, boyish, leering, all this in one face, eager, evil. And endearing. Right profile, left profile, a face unique from any view. When this face is gone, gone is fortune too.
All right, face, keep it up, keep working. There's a lot depending upon you. Whole gambling syndicate. Can't keep going on without you. Two ex-wives and all that alimony and three kids. And all their teeth to be fixed. Teeth stretching for miles and miles into the horizon. Right profile, left profile, three quarters and full face. So fill it up with tax and fill it out with wax. Oh, what an actor, climax factor, and this time.
Someone in this world thinks you're wonderful. Someone sees how marvelous you are.
You don't know how much this someone worships you, and not from afar. Who do you love you? I've seen nothing to match such pure conceit. You're so sold on yourself, it's sort of sweet. You're what you enjoy. Boy, it's boy meets boy. You're just what you deserve, so stay true blue. Love you from the moment you saw you, how your heart began to pound. It was not infatuation, no, it was much more profound. Then you smiled and you trembled, and the thunder rolled above. And that day you can't forget, as you lit your cigarette, you just knew it was love. Mm-hmm. Do you dig you? Ooh, your gun on you. It's so touching to see a love so deep. Sentimental old me can't help but weep. Let them say it's wrong. Love like yours is strong. You found your Mr. Right. It's you know.
Was Linda Lavin singing to Jack Cassidy, and It's a Bird, It's a Plane, It's Superman, a nice flip understanding of what it is to put down someone who's an egotistical maniac. And that's what we're looking at today, people who have confidence in Broadway musicals. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, and we're going to enter the summer months soon. We're going to enter Tony season in a couple of weeks, so do stick around for our annual 50th anniversary, or our Tonys 50 years before, so in the 1972 Tonys, and the very complicated 2022 Tonys. Well, let's listen to two ladies who have very different ideas about their own self-esteem. This is Michelle Lee as Gittel Mosca from the musical Seesaw from 1973.
If you gave the man your number and the man calls, and he seems a little nervous and shy, you don't make him shyer or nervouser. You help him out. At least you try. Or he's just gonna say goodbye. Which is exactly what he said. Goodbye. When it comes to men, do I ever do what's right? Any year, any month, any morning, afternoon, or night. If there's a wrong way to say it, a wrong way to play it, nobody does it like me. If there's a wrong way to do it, a right way to screw it up, nobody does it like me. I've got a big loud mouth, I'm always talking much too free. If you go for tact and manners, better stay away from me. If there's a wrong way to keep it cool, the right way to be a fool, nobody does it like me. If there's a wrong bell, I ring it, a wrong note, I sing it, ha, nobody does it like me. If there's a problem, I duck it, I don't solve it, I just muck it up, nobody does it like me. And so I try to be a lady. I'm no lady, I'm a pro. a loser guy. Nobody doesn't like me. Nobody does it, no. Nobody does it. Nobody does it like me.
Then you got it. Flunked it. Step right up and strut your stuff. People tell you modesty's a virtue, but in the theater modesty can hurt you. Then you got it, flunked it. Show your assets, let them know you're proud. Your goodies you must push, stick your chest out, shake your tush. When you got it, shout it out loud. Now, Ulla, dance. Got it, show it, put your hidden treasures on display. Violinists love to play an E string, but audiences really love a G string. When you got it, shout it, let the whole world hear what you're about. Oh, clothes may make a man, all a girl needs is a tan. Then you got it, let it hang out. Remember when Ulla danced?
Yeah.
Ulla dance again! Oh! 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 Just a little girl in Sweden, my thoughtful mother gave me this advice. If nature blesses you from top to bottom, show that top to bottom, don't think twice. Now, Ulla belt.
Katie Huffman from The Producers as Ulla. She has no problem showing people what she's got. She has no anxiety whatsoever, and isn't that great? Well, we're going to go to a couple of songs here that I would say is our Carly Simon double feature. Carly Simon doesn't really have a Broadway provenance. She's recorded a bunch of Broadway songs. Her sister wrote the score to The Secret Garden. But here are two gentlemen who appeared on Broadway over the title in 1958 and below the title in 1959, singing Carly Simon's Ode to Vanity.
How do you like my new scarf?
What color is that?
Apricot, of course.
Why, of course, apricot?
Because it goes with my eyes. Very, very few people can wear apricot.
Can I borrow it sometime?
No, I'm sorry, you may not.
Why not?
I just told you, I'm the only one who can wear apricot.
You walked into the party like you were walking onto a yacht.
What?
Your hat strategically dipped below one eye. Your scarf, it was apricot.
Yes, apricot.
You had one eye in the mirror as you watched yourself gavotte. And all the girls dreamed that they'd be your partner. They'd be your partner. And your soulmate. Probably think the song is about you. You're so vain. I bet you think the song is about you.
I don't know.
Don't you?
I don't know.
Don't you?
I think you're going crazy.
You had me several years ago when I was still quite naive. When you said that we made such a pretty pair and that you would never leave.
Who are those people?
To Saratoga, and your horse naturally won. Then you flew your Learjet up to Nova Scotia to see the total eclipse of the sun.
Saratoga rhymes
with
Nova Scotia.
Where you should be all the time. And when you're not, you're with some underworld spy or the wife.
Some
of
underworld spy
wife.
What
of
are you talking
friend.
About?
You're so vain.
So vain.
There are those
Probably
girls again.
The song is about you. You're so vain.
You're so vain.
You probably think the song is about you.
Don't you? Don't you? Don't you? You're
that innuendo about my fooling around with the wife of a close friend?
Well, you are conceited and girl crazy, aren't you?
I think you're going crackers all the
way. Well, I'd rather go crackers. You think you're a jet set kid or something.
Just because I buy an apricot scarf, suddenly I'm fooling around with underworld people.
It goes with your eyes. The only thing goes with your eyes is a black eye.
You're paranoid. That's your problem. You're paranoid.
You have delusions of grandeur. That's your problem.
Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it half as good as you. I wasn't looking, but somehow you found me. I tried to hide from your love light, but like heaven above me, the spy who loved me is keeping sometimes I wish someone could. Nobody
another Carly Simon song with a couple of toes, if not a foot or two, in the Broadway, what would I say, the Broadway panoply, of course, written by Marvin Hamlisch and Carol Bayer Sager for the film The Spy Who Loved Me. Great, great song. It's important to remember how good Marvin Hamlisch was at that kind of thing. And that was sung not by Carly Simon, who sang it in the movie, but by Jennifer Holliday. So we took that film song and we sprinkled a little Broadway magic dust. Did you guess who our singers were in the previous cut of You're So Vain? Yes, that was Tony Randall and Jack Klugman. They sang in an album called The Odd Couple Sings from 1973. And I had a copy of that, of course, and I played it and played it and played it. And I don't know that you would want Jack Klugman to play Emil Beck, but the two of them certainly have a lot of fun with that particular number. Well, we're coming to a close in our show about egotists, and let us go to two of the very best who are so evenly matched that they have to kind of slug it out musically with each other, and I'm talking about Annie Oakley and Frank Butler from Annie Get Your Gun, and this is one of my favorite recordings. It is a studio recording of Doris Day and Robert Goulet singing that great Irving Berlin score, and as I understand it, they were on separate coasts when they recorded this in the studio, so they weren't even in the same room. But anything they can do, I don't think anybody can do any better. So here is Doris Day and Robert Goulet to take us out of our episode, I Have Confidence. Looking forward to seeing you next week.
Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Yeah.
So can a rat.
Any note you can reach, I can go higher.
I can sing anything higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents.
40 cents.
30 cents.
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can drink it quicker and get even sicker.
I can open any safe
without being caught.
Sure.
That's what I thought, you crook.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Yes, you can.
Anything you can wear, I can wear better. In what you wear, I'd look better than you.
In my coat.
In your vest.
In my shoes.
In your hat.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
I can fill it better.
I can do most anything.
Can you bake a pie?
No.
Neither can I.
Any note you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing anything sweeter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
can. Yes.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.